Good day, everyone, and thank you for joining me today on this new series about how to create your own tool. For everyone that was joining this video on how to create your cult, you can go and search another video. What I'm talking about here is we are going to look at how we can model and a perfect follower, because as the saying goes, you know, if you're not handsome, at least you can be handy. And so part of this lockpicking hobby is that if you can create the perfect tool for the job, it's usually a lot more enjoyable. What we have here is the master, the core from the master 6835 that I picked in my video number one. And this core is rather interesting in the sense that to save a few cents, I would assume, Master decided to not put a C-clip on this core. And instead, what they're using is, if you can see here on the side, they have like hammered one side to make it flat. And the way you get this core is by rotating it such that everything aligns, or like the flat part of the bottom of the key align, and then you can start pushing your core out. However, what you end up with is a core that is not circular on the back. And so to make your life easier, well, what you can do is create the perfect follower that will work. So in this case, you see here, this is a follower with like the right notch and a flat surface, and that will work, you know, perfectly if you just align the flat notch. Oh, and then let me do it this way to avoid losing the key pins. And then everything works. Here is your cylinder or your core. And then you can see that the flat part just align and it's absolutely perfect. So this is great. And what we are going to do today, so let me just relock this, is as you can see in the back, I've been, so my current objective is to manage to finally open these American 1100. And I've been like progressive pinning this red one, and I have the key for this one, so it's kind of easier. But like the real test, the real smoke test, is going to be when I actually manage to open these guys that have the same core. They are Master 1300, and I do not have the keys for these guys. They were extremely cheap, but you know, that will be my test. So to do that, I need to start to increase my game on a serrated pin. And I will use the help of this great gizmo from Sparrow called the revolver. And the reason is this is actually four locks in one, and it's really well done. I'm not affiliated with Sparrow, but really, it's amazing. And the way it works is you can, well, repin the whole thing, but you can also change your driver pin to whatever combination that you want, and get, you know, a progressively more difficult picking experience. But I do not want to remove 20 grub screws and deal with the mess and maybe, you know, just strip one of these thread and, you know, be very sorry. So nobody got no time for that. And my goal here is to repin the four side with this combination of pins, and we'll go in details once we do it. But you know, I will need the perfect follower for this occasion, and you can imagine there's like pins coming from every location, every side. So if you start repinning this core, it's going to be hell with like a normal follower. So what I'm going to show in this video is how to create a follower with the CAD software and then 3D print it. Okay, so the first step of this repinning is a gutting disaster. And you should probably now cover your children's eyes. Okay, so now that the revolver is empty, let's look at what we want for the follower. So the revolver itself is four core pin and cylinder and spring on each direction. And when I'm repinning, what I want to do is I want to be able to access a single pin without disturbing the three other. So for that, I need a follower with that is round, around, and then with a notch here that would let me use my tweezer to access a single pin at a time. And I did model this follower in a CAD software, except it took a little bit too long, so I will put this process in a different video. But for now, here is the final result that you can see. So this is a notch for single pin repinning. And we will see how long does the process take. So here I have arranged my four side, and the only thing that I needed to make sure is that on this key the third one is so low, and so the key pin is so long that I cannot put any kind of security pin on this, on the number three. But let's go ahead and repin everything. I will start with row number three and go front and then do the back. So I will also increase the speed so that you can see you don't have to follow the whole process. So first pin of number one, third pin of number one. Okay, now I go to number two, third pin. Number three. Okay, so this is the last pin of the first row. Now I want to have the notch on the other side to do row four and five. And for this, I'm going to use this other follower to go through and then reverse the notch location from the back. So here we are. Now the notch is in the back, and let me continue with row number four. So, spring number one. And the last of the 20 pin here with a spool. Okay, so now we just have to put the core back, and hopefully if everything was done correctly, we should have a revolver repinned. So let's see. Okay. And number four. Yep. These serrated pins are catching a little bit, but it works. Success. Now we can close this thing back. And that's it for today. Thank you for joining me. And remember the rule. Only try this at home and leave any ferrule lock to professional. Thank you. Bye.